So actually, what does health mean? Yes, very good, Michael. You can avoid junk food. Yes. What does health mean? Health is a state of absolute physical, mental, and social well-being. So you have to do everything, all this. You have to maintain a good, proper diet. You have to sleep properly. You have to drink lot of water, good diet, and exercise. So all this constitutes proper health. See, we can have proper diet and without exercise, do we have a proper health? No. We should maintain everything: exercise, food habit, sleep, water, and our positive energy. All this we have to maintain to be healthy. So physical means our body. So we have to have good physical well-being, mental well-being, mind. We should do lot of meditation, like at least 15 minutes a day of meditation to keep our mind healthy. And social well-being. What is social well-being? The way we maintain a good relationship with others, like with the friends, with the family members, teachers, and neighbors. So all this constitutes good health. It is more than just the absence of disease or infirmity. If we are without any disease, it doesn't mean we are healthy. We should do proper exercise daily. We should do meditation. We should do yoga. And we should have proper sleep. All this tells that a person is good and healthy. So, see, they've listed out what are the aspects of good health? First, happiness. You should have a positive attitude towards everything. Like, you should not worry so many things. Like, for example, if a person is worrying, "Are your mummy did not buy and give me chocolate?" If you go on worrying about that, then will you be happy? No. So you should leave everything, all that worriness, you should set aside. You should maintain a positive attitude. "Ah, mummy, Shifty did not buy and give, it's okay." So you should have that attitude. So that makes your mind happy. Next, sleep. Get at least 7 to 8 hours sleep daily. So at your age, you should sleep at least 8 to 9 hours a day. Should sleep at least 8 to 9 hours a day at your age. So sleep nicely. Even during your afternoons, you can have a small nap so that you will feel active. You'll feel energetic. So sleep also counts with your good health habit. Next, water. Drink plenty of water because water remains very important part in our body. It maintains our temperature, it removes the waste from our body, it helps in digestion. It helps in digestion of the food. We have seen in last lesson, right? Digestion. So to do proper digestion in our body, we should drink lot of water. It also helps in keeping our body cool. So that is why water is very important. Next, good diet. What does diet mean? Can we take in junk food? Is that a proper diet? No. Yes, Sivaruban, no. You should avoid junk food. Very good. You should avoid junk food. Can you eat lot of fatty items? Like lots of chips, all that, all oily items. No, yes, you should avoid fatty items. You should avoid all junk foods. You should have only proper diet, which includes lot of fruits, vegetables, and greens. Greens is what? What does greens mean? Can anyone tell me what does greens mean? Kheerai, very good, Meenaja. So at least you should eat, consume two greens twice a week. I'm saying at least twice a week. Okay. If you take in daily, that is very, very good. Yes, spinach is very Very good. Who's that?
Arun Mitran.
Arun Mitran, very good. Spinach is very, very healthy. Yes. So you should take in lots of fruits, vegetables, greens. So that constitutes very good diet. Yes, ladies' finger, all that gives you good health. So all this, a proper diet has a carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and nutrients in right proportion. So we can find vitamins and nutrients in fruits. And what else? Proteins and cereals. So everything constitutes the good diet. Yes, last one. Yes, nuts, very good nuts. Nuts gives us good fats. Okay, nuts, very good.
Badam.
Yes, badam. Lovely children, very good. Okay, let us go to next one. The last very important one is exercise. Now everything is locked down. We cannot go out and play. But you have terrace at home, right? Do you play every day? Very good. That is a kind of exercise.
Ma'am, I am broken, ma'am.
Can I do terrace gardening, ma'am?
Yes, okay, dear. Come in the chat box. Magisha. Yes, come in the chat box. So, exercise. You can do at least walking. Walking is also exercise. Walking. Tell me what are all the exercises you know. Gardening, very good, Arul Sai. That is also a kind of walking exercise. You can do gardening as well. What are the exercises you know? Yes, very good, Lokita. Cycling. Yes, yoga, running, walking, yes, playing. Very good, Shamil. You will run? Cycling, good. Yoga, skipping, very good, Girish. Skipping. Lovely. Stairs, okay. Walking up and down in the stairs is also a form of exercise. Walking, swimming. Lovely children. So all this constitutes exercise. A simple body activity is also exercise. So what is all that makes your body? It gives body movement. So running, jogging, cycling, swimming. It helps your body to move. So it becomes a body activity. So that is exercise. Exercise is a bodily activity which enhances or maintains physical fitness and overall health. So all these movements, in some or the other way, we are moving our body. So our muscles will contract and expand. It is like a form of exercise. So you understood what exercise is? Any activity, body activity, which enhances or maintains physical fitness and overall
the morning sleeping, ma'am.
I'll be louder, dear.
Ma'am, it's clear only, ma'am. You can continue.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Yeah. Next. Tell me, what are the benefits of exercise? If we do exercise, what do we get? Yes, our body will be fit, fitness, and there are lots of benefits we get by doing exercise. See, first one, your stamina will be increased. Stamina means energy level. You feel more and more energy. Yes, good, Tarneshwar. Blood circulation, it increases blood circulation. Yes, good, strong muscles. Very good, Sanmita. So a year, they have listed out the benefits of exercise. So your stamina will be increased, energy level gets increased, then you will sleep better. You will have nice sound sleep. You will feel fit and healthy. So if you don't do any exercise, you feel lazy, you feel as though you are very weak. But when you exercise daily, you will feel very fit and healthy. It sharpens your thinking. Your mind becomes very active. You can think more and more. My body gets leaner. Leaner means it loses extra fat. You can maintain your physical fitness. Yes, bones get stronger. Yes, very good children. I'm getting a lot of answers. It gives me more energy. It gives lots of energy. Muscles and bones get stronger. You can relax. When your mind and body is relaxed, active and energy, right? It releases stress. What is stress? Kanna, please, can you mute your audio? Yes, it relieves stress, like worrying. When you feel relaxed, you will be free from stress and all that worriness. So all these are benefits which we get from good exercise. So will you do exercise every day? Yes, very good. How many of you are practicing yoga and meditation at your house? Tell me. Yes, Magisha, you do yoga? Very good. Yes, Sivaruben, very good. Sanmita, lovely children. All this is to improve your physical health. Your mind becomes active. Your mind also refreshes when you do all this. Okay, you can do walking. All this is a part of exercise to maintain your physical and mental health. Okay. Now we have seen about exercise and what are the benefits of exercise. Next, we will go to the types of exercises. There are lots of types of exercise. I'm going to just elaborate two forms of exercise. Okay, like we have many forms of exercise. Can you tell me what are the forms of exercise in the chat box? Yes, cycling is also one of our exercise we do. We have aerobic, yoga, weightlifting, gymnastics. We do all that, right? Gymnastics is also form of our exercise. Okay. Yes, you will play cricket in terrace. Very good. Weightlifting, yes, Girish. That is also a form of exercise which strengthens our muscles. Do not give annotation, children. Okay, so we will go to yoga. It is one of the form of exercise. What does yoga mean? Can anyone tell me why do we do yoga?
Mind relaxation.
Yes, very good. For mind relaxation. Is that only for mind relaxation?
Yes.
In yoga, we do different asanas. Why? Yes, relax and concentration. Good. Yes, good breathing. We do pranayama for good breathing. Keeps body healthy. Your mind will be free. Very good. Yes. To energy, yes.
Hello, ma'am.
mind will be
healthy, ma'am.
Yes, it will be.
Ma'am,
Subhashree, can you mute yourself, Dakana? Come in the chat box. Yes, it improves our immunity power, body relaxation, concentration. Healthy, lovely healthy, children.
Ma'am, healthy and peaceful, ma'am.
Yes, healthy and peaceful. Very good. Okay, can you please mute your audio at the very if you come in the chat box. Okay. Do you know where did this yoga originate? Pranavi, can you mute yourself, Rakana? Very good, Sabrish. It originated in India. Pranavi, mute yourself.
Children, please mute yourself, children.
Just a minute.
Oh, very good. Okay, okay, fine.
Yes, ma'am. So yoga actually originated in India long, long back, long, long ago, like means 5,000 years ago when rishis and munis were living, yoga originated that time. They developed, rishis and munis developed yoga.
Increase memory power, ma'am.
Okay, now listen. It increases our memory power. Now listen how yoga originated. Okay, it originated long, long back. It was developed by the rishis and munis. Why did they develop yoga? You know, because in those days there were no hospitals or no medical centers. They have to maintain their body health. So what did they do? They developed yoga to maintain the proper health, to be free from pain, to be free from problems and diseases. So they developed yoga. Actually, the word yoga means union. What does the word yoga mean? Union. It is a union of mind, body, and soul. Kana, please listen. So all this combines together and gives us good health. So yoga is the combination of all this mind, body, and soul. So we do so many yoga asanas, right? All this gives proper health and pain-free life. So you understood about yoga? So what does yoga mean? It is a union of mind, soul, and body. We do yoga to be free from pains and problems and disease. Okay, so that gives you relaxation. Your mind and body will be free, relaxed. You will feel more relaxed. So that is why we in our school insist yoga and meditation. Meditation also gives you relaxation. Your mind will feel energetic, active. So will you do yoga at home? Those who are going to yoga class are very, very good. You should make use of this time. You should do some yogas at home also. Others, you can do at least meditation. At least 5 to 10 minutes of meditation. Sit at home, do meditation. Okay, very good, children. Okay. Okay, next, we have seen about yoga. Next is aerobic. What is aerobic, children? What is aerobic exercise? Physical exercise, okay. That's all? No, aerobics, Zumba dance, okay. Dancing, okay. That's all? No, aerobics. Aerobic means something related with oxygen. So aerobic exercise is something that is related with the circulatory system. Activities like walking, cycling, swimming, running, skipping, all those are called aerobic exercises. It helps to keep our heart, lungs and circulatory system healthy. Your breathing and heartbeat will increase during this aerobic activities. It involves less effort. See, cycling, walking and all, you don't have that much effort. You can do just like that. So it does not involve very much effort. That is called aerobic, something related with cardio exercise. Cardio means heart. Only your heartbeat and breathing will increase. So that is about aerobic. Anaerobic is something different. Anaerobic means something like weightlifting and
swimming next one, what, ma'am?
Walking, dear. I will read out. You can please mute yourself. I will read out. Cycling, swimming, walking, running, skipping, and hiking. All these are called aerobic exercise. And anaerobic is something that involves lot of effort, like weightlifting. All that comes under anaerobic. Gayatri, ma'am, am I audible?
Ma'am, Anita, you're audible only.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. So, children, we have seen about aspects of health, what is health, and exercise, types of exercise, benefits of exercise. Now, tell me, what are the types of games you play at home? What games you like? What games you play? Football, okay. Chess. What else? Ludo, very good. Carrom, okay. Chess. Shuttle.
Six, ma'am.
Sriyasni, I couldn't get what you want to tell. I couldn't get you, so please come in chat box. Gymnastics, okay. Please come in chat box, dear. Basketball, cycling, chess. Running race, throwball, football, hide and seek, board games, dice. Yes, very good. Caught and caught. What game is that? I don't know. Okay. Snake and ladder, fine. Football. Okay, dear. Please type in the chat box, dear. Cards, yes. Lock and key. Okay, so there are lot many games, right? So there are many games.
Riding.
Hockey, declare, okay. Okay. Games are of two types, indoor games and outdoor games. So the games which we play inside is called indoor games, like cards, carrom, chess, all that is called indoor games. Very good. Outdoor games, something which we cannot play inside. We have to play
horse riding.
That is not game. Do you play at home now? No, right? I'm asking what games you play now at home. Okay, table tennis, basket ball, football, all those are outdoor games where we need large play area. Okay, so that is about indoor and outdoor games. In next session, we will be discussing more about indoor and outdoor games and also about the sports stars. Your favorite sports stars. We can also discuss about that in the next class.
Horse ball?
Ma'am, catch and catch also an exercise, again, ma'am.
Ma'am, dodgeball.
Dodgeball, okay. Please mute, dear. You can type in the chat box. I'm reading all your answers. Okay. Sometimes you can play even crossword puzzles, chess, all that to improve your mind. It activates your mind. Okay, it refreshes your mind. So lot many exercises like chess also, it helps in you in thinking. Okay, your mind becomes active. Yes, puzzle game. Puzzles are also very good for a mind. So you can play even mind games. Okay. Now we will do recap of this. Okay, of today's session. Over to Gayatri ma'am. Gayatri ma'am.
Yes, children. Jai Gurudev. Hope you all understood what Anita ma'am had said, isn't it? Shall we have a recap on that? Till that, what ma'am has taken? Okay. I'm going to show you a picture, and you are going to find out which picture shows a healthy one. Are you all ready? I have given A, B, C. Okay. You have to tell me. It's not telling. You have to type it in the chat box. Okay. You have to type it. Which picture shows the healthy children or a child? Are you all ready for that? Yes. Okay. Hope you all are listening carefully. Because I'm going to share this. Look at that. Observe the picture now. Yes, I'm sharing it. Can you see the picture, children? Can you see the picture? Anita ma'am, can you see that? Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Now tell me, in these three pictures, which shows that healthy one? Yes, you all understood that. Yes, it's C. Okay. But I can understand that B1 is not healthy because the child is too fat and he cannot run properly, isn't it? He's eating junk food, isn't it? It looks like that, isn't it? But why you all are telling A is not correct? Why you all are telling A is not healthy? But he looks like, he looks slim only, no? He looks slim. Yes, actually. See, yes, in heart, wholeheartedly, he is not living. See, look at the face of the child. The child is so sad. So if you are healthy, means you have to be happy both in your physical and your mental thing. That is mental. Mentally, you have to be healthy, means you have to be happy and you have to make others happy. That is the real healthiness, isn't it? Now, look at the A child. The A picture shows, even though the child is healthy, physically the child is healthy, but mentally the child is unhappy. He's feeling bad. He's something bored, whatever it is, isn't it? So, those who are happy in physical and in mentally, those who are called as healthy children. So, if you want to be healthy, you have to play nicely and you have to smile nicely. Don't have any bad things in your mind, isn't it? You have to be very happy and you should not be sad all the time, isn't it, children? So now this C picture, look at the children, how happily they are playing together, isn't it? So, and even the, look at their physical condition, they are healthy, isn't it? So this picture easily tells you that healthy means you have to be physically and mentally strong. You understand? Yes. Now we'll have recap for all other things. Now, what are all the different exercise you have done? So you have learned in this session? What ma'am said? You all remember that what are all that exercises you will do, isn't it? What is the importance of exercise? Now tell me. What is the importance of exercise? Why do we need to do exercise? Are you all sharing? I'm going to show you this. So now these are all the, can you see the screen, children? Yes. Let me zoom it. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to tell you the importance of the exercise. If you do exercise, what will happen? Let me tell you one by one. Okay. So doing physical exercise helps us in the following ways. So very important thing is, first thing, your body will be flexible. The body will be flexible. What is it? Flexible. Flexible means easily you can do multi and all the time you will be playing at home, isn't it? And if you are not a healthy, means what will happen? You cannot bend, you cannot do the exercise. Like that, you will be sitting as such, means then you are unhealthy. So if you are healthy, means your body will be flexible. If you do exercise, your body will be flexible. You can easily bend yourself. You can do multi. You can play nicely. You can run nicely. You can jump nicely. Isn't it? So doing physical exercise helps to make your body flexible. What is the second point? Improves the blood circulation in our body. Why do you want to do the blood circulation? If the blood circulation is in proper way, then only the blood will run to all your parts of your body, isn't it? The blood will run all your parts of your body, isn't it? So for that, you have to do exercise properly. Do you remember that why teachers are asking you to clap your hands? Why teachers are asking you to do the brain exercise? You will put topokarnam, isn't it? Why teachers are asking you to do? Why teachers are asking you to do all these exercises in the class? Jump for 5 times, jump for 3 times. Why she's telling? It is that when you do that type of exercise, your blood will work fastly, run properly in your body. If you sit as such for a long time, what will happen? It will settle down, isn't it? It will become slow. If it runs fastly and the blood will go to your brain and it will go to all parts of your body, very good flow is there in your brain, the blood flows in your brain properly, means what will happen? Your brain will become very happy. If your brain becomes happy, then you will become happy and you will start learning and listen properly. So what the exercise does, it improves the blood circulation in our body. Yes. What is the third point? It makes us feel energetic and fresh. Everything is interrelated, isn't it? If you are fresh, if your blood is flowing properly in your body, how you will feel? You will feel energetic. You will start listening carefully to your teacher and you will happily listen to the teacher, isn't it? In the class also, after jumping for 5 times, you will be very happy and you will sit quietly and you will listen to your teacher, isn't it? And you will feel energetic. That is why everything is interrelated, isn't it? Correct? Okay, now what is the fourth point? It gives us more energy to work. Simple. So if you want to work, you have to have energy, isn't it? For that, you have to do this exercise continuously. It is not that doing exercise only one day in a week. It should not be like that. At least 4 times, per week. Okay, you can do it, isn't it? So, or if it is fine, you can do it every day for half an hour. You can do the exercise every day. Isn't it, children? You have to do. So, if you do exercise like that, you will get more energy and you can work properly. Half an hour of exercise, it will give you more energy. And the whole day, you can work out properly. Isn't it, children? Yes. So, the fourth point, it gives more energy. And what is the last point? Combined of all the things, finally, we become active and healthy by exercising regularly. So it is simple sentence, isn't it? You will become active. So if I ask any question to a child who's sitting for a longer time, if I ask something to that child, means you will not listen anything, you will be as such.
3 months, 7 more minutes.
Yes, ma'am, having grumpy face, isn't it? use it as such. I don't know, ma'am. You'll tell like that. If the child, if I ask you to make an exercise, okay, 5 times jump, and after that you will sit, you will become very active, isn't it? And once ma'am asks questions, you will start answering very well, isn't it? So that's what everything means, that if you do exercise, we have five important points. Just I'm going to underline the points. Listen carefully. Okay. So what you have to do? First is, body will become flexible. Body will become flexible. So you can do any work, isn't it? Second point, improves the blood circulation. Improves the blood circulation. What is the third point? You will feel energetic and fresh. And what is the fourth point? You will get more energy to work. And finally, you will become active and healthy by exercising regularly. So it is not exercising once in a week like that. You have to do it regularly. Okay, children? So now you understand? You understood what is the importance of doing exercise? Yes. Let me move to the... What else? Mentally, you have to be fit. I told you that point, isn't it? It is not only your physical healthiness. You have to be both physically and mentally, you have to be fit. Mentally fit means what? It is you must have friends. You have to talk to your friends. You have to talk to your classmates freely without making all the time fighting with others. You should not be like that. If you're fighting me, then you are not healthy, isn't it? So all the time, if you're fighting means no one will come and talk to you. Am I right, children? So if you're happy and you're making others happy means you will be having more friends. Am I right, children? Yes. And you have to play, how you have to improve your mental fitness? By talking to your friends. And doing some brain teasers, it's like a puzzle game, okay? Next one, quality time with your family members. Quality time with your family members, all the time sitting at home and seeing the TV, watching the TV and seeing the gadgets. Instead of that, you have to talk to your father, you have to talk to your mother. No, more important thing is you have to talk to your grandparents. Sit nicely and listen to the stories, what they are telling. Just converse with them. If they are not with you, at least with the phone calls, you can talk to them. That is called quality time. Talk to your family members. Talk to your grandparents. They will be very happy when they talk to you. Isn't it, children? If you have grandparents at home, sit with them and ask them to tell some stories. So that isn't all quality time. If you do so, mentally, you will become really fit. And finally, mental stimulating games like problem-solving puzzles, riddles, that type of games you have to. So if you want mentally fit means you must have friends, you have to play games like indoor games like chess and all. It will make you sharp, isn't it? It will make you to think more, isn't it? And spending quality time with your family members. Play with your brother, play with your sister, play with your parents, talk to your grandparents. Okay, these are all the important things so you can have mental fitness. Let me move to the next session. Okay, next slide. Yes, ma'am told about indoor and outdoor games, isn't it, children? So games like chess. So for that, to play a chess, you need only a small...
Ma'am, two more minutes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It's over. Yes, what are all the games you play in the ground, that we play outside of the house, isn't it? That and all called as outdoor games or outdoor sports. And indoor games means all the board games, isn't it? Everything comes under indoor games. So both the games are equally, you have to give equal importance. So most of the indoor games, when you play, it will make your mind sharp. Like for example, chess and Ludo, everything. Even Ludo will make you to think properly, calculative. You have to think properly, isn't it? And outdoor games makes your body fit. And indoor games makes your mind fit. In this situation, children, kindly stick on to the indoor games. Don't worry, soon it will be, everything will be fine. And don't worry, be happy for all the time and play games. Have a nice day. Thank you, children. Anita, ma'am, anything want to? That's all, children, for today.
That's all. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, children. Okay.